Before starting this video, I'd like to give a shout out to the sponsor glazeding.com. These guys have one of the best tempered glasses for the majority of the smartphones, their real curved collection, and the UV glasses are one of the best that I've ever used on a smartphone. So if you guys want the best tempered glass for your phone, do check out glazeding.com. Check out their UV glasses as well as their 2.5D curved tempered glasses. You can also use the promo code Gizmo for 10% discount. Hey guys, Gizmoddict here, and today we're gonna unbox the Xiaomi Redmi Note 8 Pro. So this phone actually is a drastic change from the Redmi Note 7 Pro. It's been already launched in China and it's coming to India very soon, I think in the month of October. So because this phone is already launched in China, I imported my unit from there. So this is the Chinese unit of the Redmi Note 8 Pro. And along with that, I also have this Black Shark gamepad, which is compatible with this phone. So we're going to unbox these two accessories. I'm going to talk about the Redmi Note 8 Pro. We'll take a quick hands-on review as well. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. And if you guys don't want to miss out such videos in the future, please make sure to hit the red subscribe button and press the bell icon, because a lot of videos about the Redmi Note 8 Pro are coming to the channel very soon. Okay, so first of all, we're gonna take a look at the box of the Redmi Note 8 Pro, and as you can see, like other Xiaomi devices, this also comes in a very minimalistic packaging. You've got a gradient color on the front, so you've got this red gradient on the front, and if you see, you've got the Redmi Note 8 Pro branding, you've got the small Mi branding in the top right, and once again on the sides, you've got the Redmi Note 8 Pro branding. If we check the back of the box, you've got a couple of specifications written, but then once again, these are in Chinese, so we're not gonna read that. So anyways, let's just jump in and see what we get inside the box. So inside the box, the first thing that we have is a small piece of cardboard in which you have the TPU case as well as the paperwork for the phone. Now all of this is gonna be in Chinese, so let's not read that, but yeah, you do get a TPU case with the phone as you do with any other Xiaomi phone. Moving on further, we can see the Redmi Note 8 Pro inside. So let's get it out of box, and as you can see, I've ordered it in the green shade. So there is this new emerald green type shade of the Redmi Note 8 Pro, so I've ordered that. But anyways, I'm gonna keep this phone to the side as of now and see what else do we get inside the box. So further inside, you've got a USB cable. So this is your Type-C to Type-A USB cable, which is similar to what I got with the Redmi K20 Pro as well. And you've got a power brick. So this phone supports 18 watt fast charging, I think. So this is the 18 watt adapter, and there is quick charging 4.0 support on the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So as you can see, this charging brick is very similar to what you get on the Redmi K20 or the K20 Pro. So it supports 2 amperes at 9 volts, and it also supports 3 amperes at 5 volts. So as you can see, it can support up to 3 ampere charging, which is good. But anyways, that's all you get inside the box of the Redmi Note 8 Pro. Now let's move on and unbox the Black Shark controller for the Note 8 Pro. So this Black Shark controller comes in this black and green box, which looks very attractive, which is the Black Shark color scheme. So inside this box, you get the controller itself and you get a small piece of paperwork. So on that, you've got the QR code and the instructions on how to set up and download the Black Shark app. And also, because this is kind of a universal controller for Xiaomi phones, you have to separately get a bracket as well. So as of now, this bracket is only available for Black Shark phone, Redmi K20 if I'm not wrong, and for the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So I've got the Redmi Note 8 Pro bracket. So how you're supposed to use it is that you're supposed to put the case on the phone, then you put the bracket, and then you slot the controller in. I'm gonna talk about this later on, but this is what you get with the controller. Now let's move on to the Redmi Note 8 Pro and talk about it. So here's the Redmi Note 8 Pro, and honestly, I'm blown away by how this device looks and feels in the hand. On the front, you've got a 6.53 inch display. So this is an IPS LCD Full HD Plus display. Looks pretty good. It's not an AMOLED display, but considering how this phone has been priced, I think that's completely fine. And then if you talk about the notch, you've once again got a dewdrop notch. So this is not like the U notch. It's more like a V notch that we see on Realme phones. So that's not a big deal. That's a minor change in comparison to the Redmi Note 7. And if you talk about the back, here's where you've got the major change, because you've got 4 cameras on the back instead of 2 on the Redmi Note 7. So you've got a primary Samsung sensor, which is a 64 megapixel sensor. Apart from that, you've got an 8 megapixel of wide angle sensor, 2 megapixel macro lens, and another 2 megapixel lens for portrait mode. So all in all, you've got a quad camera setup, which is very similar to the Realme XT. And I'm really excited to see how this camera performs on the Redmi Note 8 Pro. The back once again is made out of glass. So the front glass and the back glass is covered with Gorilla Glass 5, and I really love the design of the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So as you can see, this is kind of an emerald green shade. It's a very dark shade of green, and it actually looks different in different angles. So in some angles, it might look like a very, very dark shade of green, almost like black. And the moment you twist it and it reflects light from another angle, it looks this shimmery emerald green, which looks really beautiful. I really love the color combination of this phone. It doesn't really look that evident on camera, but then when you see it in person, it actually looks much better than what you can see on the screen right now. So yeah, design and build quality wise, the Redmi Note 8 Pro is no slouch. You've got glass body, you've got quad camera setup, you've got this really nice shades, and on the front you've got a dewdrop notch. So all in all, no complaints with the design and the build quality. So that's all about the outside. Now let's move on to the inside, because here's where things get really interesting. So the Redmi Note 8 Pro gets the MediaTek Helio G90T processor, which is a very powerful octa-core processor. You've also got 6GB of RAM and 64GB on storage on the variant that I have. The G90T is a new chipset that was launched by MediaTek. It's a 12 nanometer processor, and it's majorly aimed at gaming. So PUBG lovers are definitely gonna like this. You've also got 4,500 mAh of battery. So compared to 4,000 mAh on the Note 7 Pro, you've got 500 mAh extra. So that's a nice thing to have. And you've also got all of the other things like the headphone jack. You've got the Type-C port at the bottom. And this phone, like I said before, supports Qualcomm Quick Charging 4.0. In terms of software, because this is a Chinese variant, you've got the Chinese version of MIUI. So there is no Google Play Store or anything like that on it. But it was very easy to install it. I barely took 5 minutes to install all of the Google services on the Redmi Note 8 Pro, and then I was good to go. See, on the software front, it's very similar. If you've used any phone with MIUI 10, it's gonna be very, very similar. Although you've got a couple of other features like Game Turbo, which I think weren't present on the Redmi Note 7 Pro. I'm not sure, don't quote me on that, but this phone does get the Game Turbo feature, which comes in very handy if you're gonna play a lot of games. And in terms of biometric, you've got a fingerprint sensor on the back of the phone. So there is no, you know, in-display fingerprint sensor like we've seen with the Mi A3. You've got a proper physical sensor on the back. But I have one gripe with it. It's too flush with the camera sensors. So actually, initially you feel that you're touching the camera sensor and not the fingerprint sensor. If they would have separated the sensor a little bit downwards as compared to the cameras, then it would be really easy to recognize the sensor. So yeah, that is one thing that you need to get used to when you're gonna use the Redmi Note 8 Pro. But so far the phone looks pretty promising. I have a couple of concerns with it though, because there is a MediaTek processor on it. I'm not really sure if Google camera apps are gonna work, because I've checked for the camera to APS support, and while there is support for it, none of the Google camera APKs right now are working on the Redmi Note 8 Pro. So if this is gonna be the case, then this phone might suffer a lot in terms of cameras. So let's see how that thing goes. So that is one thing which is pretty dicey, because the Redmi Note 7 Pro did have a very good Google camera support. And if I talk about the controller, actually I'm gonna make a separate dedicated video covering this controller, but yes, you can play PUBG with it. It's very easy to use. I could set it up within 5 minutes, and you can easily map the buttons on the controller to the on-screen game controls. So this is gonna be a very interesting video. PUBG does run on smooth plus extreme settings, and a lot of you guys have questions about the overheating issue on this phone as well. So my detailed PUBG review should be available either by tomorrow or day after. So make sure that you subscribe so that you don't miss out on that video. I'll be covering everything like FPS, overheating, battery drain, and I'll also be covering this controller in that video. So don't miss that video out. But so far, like I said, the Redmi Note 8 Pro seems to be a very promising device. I'll be getting my Realme XT very soon as well. So the first sale is on 16 September for the Realme XT. So I'll buy it in that sale, and then I'll compare it with the Redmi Note 8 Pro. As of now, this is all I have to say with respect to the unboxing as well as my first impressions of the Redmi Note 8 Pro. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, please hit the like button. If you're new here, then subscribe and do share this video with your friends. I'm actually gonna put a lot of updates about the Note 8 Pro and some other devices on my Instagram page as well as on my Twitter page. So if you guys don't want to miss that out, make sure that you follow me there, because I will post some behind the scenes content as well as my experience while using the phone. So don't miss that out. Go follow me on Twitter and Instagram. Anyways, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna be back in your notifications very, very soon. Peace.